ready to try something different?
Let me stop you there. Let's put some skates on you.
Yeah, give me the basic. Give me the basic.
I'm all about the basic beginner level.
I'm going to be in the house like...
What's going on, Milwaukee? This is DJ GA, and I've got something special for you coming up right now.
I'm Greg Adams. As a primetime radio DJ and known voice of Milwaukee, I want to use my voice to shine a light on people, places, and vibes that make Milwaukee so special. There's more to our city than just cheese and beer. So a few of our notable neighbors are joining me to explore our city. It's time for them to show me Milwaukee. I'm in the Sherman Park neighborhood meeting up with Shar Borg, real estate agent to some of Milwaukee's biggest names. She's really passionate about community builders. And today we're exploring the amazing ways people are coming together in our city.
This is your stomping grounds.
Right.
Where'd you grow up at?
I grew up in Baltimore, but I came here for work for a 3-year contract. I used to be a news reporter at WISN.
I did a little research, like with the Emmy or something like that.
Nominated for an Emmy for breaking news, and that was really, really special. Thank you,
okay.
And here I am 26 years later.
How do you love Milwaukee so much? It's specifically Sherman Park.
So my husband and I bought our first house here. We love the community here. And so we've been in Sherman Park for 24 years.
What are you doing now?
I've been in real estate for the past 17 years. Some of my clients are the Milwaukee Bucks.
I'm
not kidding you.
You know Giannis?
I do know Giannis. He's good people.
Did you find a house big enough for him?
Well, they're very tall. So really, right. It's not about how big as much as it is about how tall. And yes, they fit in the house.
You're really like tied into the community.
Sherman Park is all about community and everybody is welcome here. And Trickleby is like the restaurant where everybody is welcome.
Well then, we're here.
Let's go.
Okay, I've heard about Trickleby, so I'm excited to jump in and help feed this community.
Good morning. Welcome to Trickleby.
Greg.
Hi, Christy. Good to see you.
What's going on here?
We are a pay-what-you-can community cafe. And if people have nothing at all, they can volunteer for a meal.
Somebody can come in here with no money. Just be like, hey.
Totally. Happens every day.
How do you get the food?
A whole bunch of our produce is donated. People garden and bring us their excess. We have 3 garden plots, so you can't get more fresh food in this area.
I see the garden.
Yeah, so it's as organic as possible, as local as possible, and always made from plants.
So it's healthy all around.
It is healthy, and some neighbors come in because they say their doctor said they have to eat better.
So it's really like a community thing. Huh?
Totally. We share our kitchen with local food entrepreneurs outside of our business hours. We figure if we have the kitchen, we should make it available.
Absolutely. Yeah.
My heart is melting right now. The more I hear about this place, the more I need to be here. If I volunteered, you'd put me in the kitchen.
There's always something to work on.
Well, I got time today.
I got time too. No, I don't have a lot of experience.
We'll train you up. Let's go.
Awesome.
All
right.
Let's do it. Well, I have projects for everybody. We're going to do jalapeno pepper poppers. Think you can handle that? Just got to be careful not to get the hot stuff in your eyeball.
My glasses, I got it. I'm good.
Okay,
I'm good.
Awesome. And then Shar, I'm going to have you help with shucking corn.
Shucking with Shar. I can do that.
So
easy.
This is Ann. Ann is our cafe manager, so you'll be shucking out here, and then we'll get in on those pepper poppers.
Let's go.
Sounds good.
Right. Have fun shucking.
So we're taking these jalapenos, which are a little spicy. Cut that stem off, cut them in half. We're going to take the seeds out, so that's the hottest part of the pepper.
Wow, I did not know that.
Yeah.
I'm not a big spicy person, but I like a little spice from time to time. How was the menu?
We've never served the same thing twice.
Really?
Even if we try to serve the same thing, it's different because it's based on what vegetables we have that week.
And just with you being a restaurant in the city, how do you think you back up to all the other restaurants?
People think because it's pay what you can that the food will be sort of subpar.
You know what? Yeah.
But it's not. We do not cut corners here. It is like all fresh, and I would even say sometimes kind of gourmet. And people come in and they're delighted. And then we're gonna fill them with vegan cream cheese and fresh dill. That's how they look when they're done. Kinda cute, right?
Are people just gonna eat it like corn on the cob or?
So we're making soup with the corn tomorrow. We're composting the husk, so you can put it in this bucket down here.
I've noticed you guys don't waste anything here. Yeah. If it can be recycled or composted, that's what you do.
Yeah, we throw 1 trash bag, like a tall kitchen bag of trash out a week.
For a restaurant for the whole week.
That serves like 200 plus people a week. Yeah. Because everything else is composted or recycled. And food doesn't have packages, right? I mean.
Right. Yeah. That makes a lot of sense. I think I split this one. Look, I split it.
How long have you been volunteering here?
It's I started volunteering here when I was in college. It's a calling for sure. I like cooking for people and meeting new people and talking to them. People come here and like meet other in the community that they can bond with. It's also like skill building for people when they come here to volunteer. One after another like relationship built like that, and like that's how community is built.
That's beautiful. So you're growing skill sets in people, you're growing a sense of value in your customers, and you're growing community.
You want to try the cookie dough?
The trick will be we like to sample our food.
Uh-oh.
When we do it. So this is for you.
All right, try the cookie dough.
We didn't talk about that either. So yeah. What's on the menu?
Yeah, it's a veggie noodle soup. So we have brown rice noodles, and we have a spaghetti sauce with chickpea noodles. And then we've got these pepper poppers and the cookie. So you gotta tell us how it stacks up.
And this right here?
Pretty good.
Oh, it's real good.
Awesome.
I'm ready to eat.
Well, you're earning your meal by helping.
We're almost done here.
Wasn't too bad.
How's it going out here?
Almost done now.
Second along, I see.
Hanging out with Aunt.
We really appreciate the help here.
All right, Cindy. We've got the spaghetti, so we'll get that plated. And Rachel's getting the soup.
It looks real good. Yes.
And then you all can eat and taste the fruits of your labor. Yeah.
Ding. That's what I'm talking about.
Do you want to grab one?
Fantastic.
Thank you for helping today too. You got to see the whole thing in action.
It was really awesome.
I was watching the soup back there, so I'm really trying to try this first. Oh, that's real good.
Oh my goodness. Like, it tastes like chicken noodle soup.
I know, right? Yes.
You loving it?
Okay, I'm trying to understand like how you get all these textures. I mean, everything is vegan here,
everything,
right?
Everything made from plants.
And our family, the philosophy is if it don't include meat, it's
right.
Not a meal.
A lot of people think that way, but you have to still have the fats to carry the flavor. So we use a lot of oils and we bake with like chickpea noodles and flax and things like that.
Do you have a cookbook?
Publishing one this fall, yeah. And it'll also be a pay what you can cookbook.
Oh my gosh, I love it. How'd you come up with the name Tricklebee?
I was a little kid and I heard my mom say, yeah, we could do that thing. The trick will be finding the right people. The trick will be getting enough money.
Oh,
I heard it as the Tricklebee.
Tricklebee.
Yeah. It's a made up word. And so now the Tricklebee running a cafe with all plants
be.
And people could pay what they want.
The Tricklebee making it taste like it has meat in it. You killed it.
Yeah, thank you. But we didn't kill it. That's right. Well, enjoy the rest of it. Thank you.
Hey, thank you. The Tricklebee. How soon can I get back here?
Right? The trickle bee, because I'll make it taste like this when I cook it at home. You gonna be brave enough to try the jalapeno popper? You made it.
Let me see how spicy it is. Let me see how spicy it is. It's a little spicy, but I found this out today working in the kitchen making this. All the spice and seeds.
Oh, are there any seeds in here?
No.
All right, well then then let me try it.
So much to this place. You can ride by this place and just, oh, it's just enough. But you come in here, just the garden, the food, you would never think it was right here.
In Sherman Park.
Sherman Park.
This right here, to me, is like the heart and soul of Milwaukee.
You can never go hungry in Sherman Park, and that's beautiful.
Ooh, I love it. You ready to try something different?
Man, you know it, it's your day, I'm following you.
All right, well, we'll see what we're up to next.
Next, Shar gets me rolling into a new hobby.
I'm like really concentrating.
And I go deep into the meaning of this signature lasagna.
This ain't lasagna, this life.
Shar and I just finished volunteering at Tricklebee. Now we're on the east side, headed to a studio on North Ave for...
roller skating.
Well, actually, roller dancing.
I'm gonna tell you just like this. The Tricklebee, me not falling, because, yeah. I want you to look at that.
Now this looks like something I could get into. Ellen and Terrence are the co-owners of Roll Train, and I am ready to learn some new moves from them.
Okay. I gotta tell you, like a crazy thing happens. My daughter and I were coming from the listing, and we saw these two people like skating down the street. It looked like good exercise, but it looked like fun too, right? And so then the next thing you knew, like I was trying to figure out who was doing this in Milwaukee and found you guys.
Like what made you guys start that?
This started after a trip she took to San Francisco.
And I'm like, okay, why isn't this in Milwaukee. We've got enough skaters here and enough people that taught me how to skate. Like, let's go.
Who is in your skating community?
Our class is for everybody.
The word we use is called skate fan.
Well, I'm gonna be one of those people.
Exactly. Yeah.
Let me stop you there. Let's put some skates on you.
You are already?
Yes.
I'm ready.
You got a 13 somewhere?
Size 13, V9. Size 13, right here.
All right.
Now look, I roller skated as a kid, but I have no clue how to roller dance. This is going to be interesting.
Every city has their own style.
Oh, so this is Milwaukee style.
What's Milwaukee style?
Milwaukee's more of a bounce.
We just bouncing in Milwaukee. I got it.
We're going to do the basic beginner level.
Yeah, give me the basic. Give me the basic.
I'm all about the basic beginner level.
All right, here we go.
Bend the knees, posture forward.
Just put the one forward.
All right, this is a little harder than I thought.
I'm like really concentrating. Yeah.
One, two. Don't
jump. I can hear
you. He's like, I can't hear you, Shar.
One, two. One,
okay.
Two.
Starting to get the hang of this.
Oh, I see.
Well, almost.
Bring it back up.
But we've learned enough to get into our first routine.
First beginner routine that we do is called slide.
I may not be graceful, but at least I'm standing. Or rolling?
Next time I come back here, we're gonna do the routine. I'm gonna go grab some skates tomorrow.
When you become a skater, you become part of the skate fan.
I'm gonna be in the house
I feel like I accomplished something.
You did.
You know?
You got a workout.
This is like one of the best kept secrets in Milwaukee.
I had no idea.
I just saw the people skating down the street. I was like, I wanna be like them.
Well, I appreciate y'all having us. I really do. Can I skate backwards out of here?
Oh, you can't do that. You can't, I got it. You don't know nothing about that.
I sure don't.
Shar and I have definitely worked up an appetite with the skate fan. So she's taking me to the near west side to meet the food fan.
Daddy's Soul Food and Grill, huh?
This is the spot right here.
Hey, after roller skating, I'm ready.
Thank you.
How you doing? Great.
Welcome to Daddy's. I'm Chef Benjamin.
Okay. Hi, Chef Benjamin. I'm Shar.
Hi, Shar. Nice to meet you
both. Yeah, thanks for having us.
It seems like you got a lot going on in here.
We do have the soul food, but also we have the grill items.
I keep smelling that food. What you got back there?
Because we do have baked chicken, fried chicken, and catfish every day. Okay. But each day we have a special. Today just happens to be our specialty homemade lasagna. So, are you be our tester today?
I'll definitely be a tester. which way are we going?
Let's go.
All right.
And there's a big story behind this lasagna. My dad always told me when we made the lasagna, the reason why I have it on my menu, a lot of things happen in life and it makes you grow. And it's a metaphor that he talked to me about. I just said, oh my God, I love that.
Lasagna as a metaphor for life. Right. Yes. I love it.
So we're gonna go ahead and start making it. Okay. Each layer is intertwined with the other layer.
Okay. Oh.
Such is life.
The layers of life intertwined.
Lasagna is so much of a metaphor. Noodle is actually your framework. Okay. It's actually what holds everything together. And that hard shell represents that unbroken part. And eventually it's gonna be soft. It comes in hard.
But it's right.
But that's good about layer. You know, sometimes people are hard on the outside.
Yep, and then they gotta get softened up.
Outside. They now they soft on the inside. You wanna go ahead and pour it in your binder. I'm gonna create some air and I'll whip up this ricotta and eggs, add the seasoning.
You wanna just pour it in there?
Just pour it right on in there.
Oh!
That's aroma.
That's aroma.
Pour that sugar in
they
there.
They do say I'm sweet.
You're supposed to take your time,
No, you just dump it in there.
Dump it in there.
Chef Greg's put all
so that. So just the whole pour thing inside that pan. This is the heart of the meal. All this is interchangeable, but this stays the same. Just like you get older, you're not the same when you're an adolescent. but you still have that body.
Right.
You change when you get a little older. Right. And so we're gonna add what we wanna put in as our character.
Right.
So
right.
Now this is the choices we make.
All right, so now we're gonna, you want me to put the turkey in? So I can just kinda dump it
absolutely.
In there.
Now you gotta, that's the body now.
That's the body. Everybody's body is not the same though. This ain't gonna be no skinny body right here.
Everything else, you know, sometimes life can be bland, but it's up to you. To
give it some flavor.
Put some flavor in.
Spice it up.
You know, spice it up.
The final layer is what holds me stable. You hold that in with values because you've created a masterpiece. Yeah. You don't want to just fly in the wind.
Right.
You
need
something to be, keep you stable, right?
That's right.
Watch out there now. I feel
right?
Something.
Okay.
This ain't lasagna. This life.
As we crown it with the sauce.
I like how you did
it. It holds all that in place. Also giving that flavor.
Lasagna is life.
Lasagna is
who would have thought?
Look.
Your dad?
Hey, all I'm saying is I'll never look at lasagna the same.
Who doesn't love cheese?
I mean, you know, we are in Wisconsin.
Right. Not only does it protect the cap, but it also crowns and it seals and it flavors.
I see your dad really showed you how to do this lasagna, but is that Daddy's Soul Food and Grill?
Named after my father. You know, when I talk about my dad, it kind of tears me up because he was a rock to me.
Was he around when you started the restaurant?
So
he didn't get to see the vision?
No, unfortunately, he was diagnosed with lymphoma cancer.
Oh, wow.
Here I can, you know, honor my dad as well as start my own dream. And when I look out in the lobby and see the family eating, I said, that's my vision.
I totally get this whole concept.
We're gonna plate up this delicious food that we all made today.
Wonderful.
And we're gonna bring it out to you.
Thank you so much for inviting us into your family kitchen.
I learned so much about life.
This is gonna be the most meaningful lasagna I've ever had. It's amazing to see how Chef Benjamin and his family are intentionally building a place for families to gather.
This is the lasagna that we made.
It looks
and
so good.
And a homemade farm-raised catfish.
Oh, yeah.
I hope you guys enjoy.
Let's try our handiwork here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh my goodness.
Wait, let me try a piece of this catfish.
Oh, the catfish. Hello, catfish.
Light and flaky, too. It's seasoned. It's real good.
Was it everything that I built it to be?
You see it. Oh, you see it.
So are you ready to go to our last event of the day?
I think I am. All I am energized right. After that food.
Hey, let's go hear some great music at Washington Park.
Coming up, Shar shows me her community hangout.
This is my absolute favorite thing to do on Wednesday night.
And we get backstage before the concert.
I found this creative scene in Milwaukee.
Shar and I are wrapping up our special day with a community gathering and concert here at Washington Park.
This is my absolute favorite thing to do on Wednesday nights with my family. Obviously, the music is going to be on point.
Okay.
There's so many awesome food trucks to choose from, and then there's live art, and then like all these families out here just having a really good time.
Wow. This is definitely a party.
Hey.
Hey.
How are you?
Greg.
Hi, and I'm Jane Conkle of Washington Park Neighbors. We're the nonprofit that organizes Washington Park Wednesdays at this beautiful 84-year-old band shell.
It's 84 years old?
It's built to bring people together.
When me and Shar were walking down here, I just couldn't help but notice how beautiful the park is.
Yes, designed by landscape architect Frederick Law Olmsted.
And Olmsted is the designer who did Central Park in New York.
Correct. Lake Park here in Milwaukee.
Correct.
Wow, so big name.
His idea, much like ours, was to bring all kinds of people to this park. This park has been called the People's Park, which I think is so perfect because a lot of people are involved in building and maintaining the community that we've helped establish here.
Community, community.
It's everything.
Community.
Well, these people here are this park's finest work, really. And that's why we're here, so.
It looks like the bands are starting to warm up. And I think my guy, Dima, is down there.
Our stage manager from the new state.
Oh, he's a...
Yeah, come talk to Dima. Come on.
Dima is a big advocate for the music community here in Milwaukee. It's kind of fun to see my world and Shar's world coming together.
Yeah, what's up, man? Good to see you again. Long time no see.
I know, right? I know, right?
Shar, nice to meet you.
How did you even start doing this?
My passion goes way back. I've always come here to the park to enjoy some great music.
Shar, you you started coming here every Wednesday.
My kids have grown up coming here.
Then you were coming here and now you work here.
I found this creative scene in Milwaukee, untapped, so much talent. Finally this year, they asked our organization, the New State and Westside Arts Unlimited, to participate in stage management, stage support. And we train young individuals, giving them skills in production, music, that could hopefully turn into careers in the future. That's kind of our mission. So this was a perfect connector. We can support you guys, help you with some stage management. We can teach some young individuals how to stage manage.
That's what it's all about.
Providing opportunities for community to come together to experience and enjoy music, experience and enjoy vendors. We got live art, engaging with the crowd that's here, giving opportunity for young people and adults to come up and draw, paint, give them some tips and tricks. So it's gonna be interactive and it's gonna be a lot of fun. Yeah.
What great best kept secrets in Milwaukee, right here at Washington Park.
This is one of the best.
Who's playing tonight?
Yeah, tonight we have an amazing, amazing performance by a band, Kojo. It's a collaboration between several reggaeton, reggae artists.
You ready for a show?
I'm ready for a show.
We're gonna go ahead and head up then.
Enjoy the show. I got some work to do and training to do.
Yes, you do.
So nice to meet you. Thank you.
Have a go.
Even though our city is still healing from a history of separation, seeing so many people from different backgrounds coming together in the heart of Milwaukee, it's a great feeling.
So here you go, have a seat.
This is how we'll do it, yeah.
This is like a for real community event.
Out here.
You have spent a classic day, and now we're gonna end the day with some great Caribbean music.
And we got some of the best seats in the house.
Thanks to Shar, I had front row seats all day long to some important people, places, and stories that are building strong communities in our city. We started off the day at Trickleby's serving our neighbors. Then we joined the Skate Fam at Road Train. And we enjoyed making food for the soul at Daddy's. Now I'm just chilling with my neighbors at Washington Park.
The Trickle B topping this day.
It's community, community, community. Gotta love Milwaukee.
Gotta love Milwaukee.
On another adventure, I meet up with Wisconsin travel creator, Chellsie Memmel. She's gonna show me the wild side of Milwaukee.
Onward, Captain.
We can try and angle out of the tree a little bit.
I need to spend the night in here.
You're not afraid of heights, are you, Greg?
Milwaukee is wild.